This video shows how to install and use Lync. Go to the UHI website, click on Staff and go to the page where you can log into Webmail. Use your usual UHI ID and password to log in. When Webmail is open, you are taken to your inbox. Click on the Home link at the top of the page and you will see the link to download and install Lync. If you are logged into Webmail, Lync will pick up your credentials and signing in the first time is easier. Choose the appropriate version for your PC and click the Install button. I am using Firefox, so I have to save the file and then run it, but in Internet Explorer you can run directly. While we wait for the download, I'll just mention this utility which you can use if you experience difficulty logging in for the first time. Sometimes Lync takes a long time to sign in on first use, but thereafter it doesn't take long at all. There is an iPad app which works pretty well but will only do text messaging. If you have not previously used Lync, you will have no contacts. I have a number of contacts showing with green, yellow or red availability. Those with no colour are currently offline. To add a contact who's not on your list, enter the name in the search box, and when suggestions are shown, you can hover over the name and click on the Add button to add the name to your contacts. You can add your location or any daily message on the top of the window. You can use Lync to do audio and video calls as well as text messaging, and in that case you may wish to check your audio and video settings. Click on the arrow beside the cog wheel on the top right and select Tools, then Options from the menu. I have found that Lync picks up the devices accurately, so it is most likely that no changes are necessary. Here you can check your outgoing video. Try to position yourself within the frame. I have only one video device. I'm now going to look at the audio devices, as my webcam has a microphone and my headset has a microphone. I usually use the one on the headset. Here you can also test your audio volumes. Hovering over a name in your contacts throws up another window and you can see that it is possible to email from Lync. If you want to send a text message, you would click this button. Type your message in the bottom half of the chat window and it is moved to the top half when you hit the Enter key. You can send small files by clicking on the paperclip icon. Use UHI Dropbox for sending large-sized files. The recipient has the opportunity to accept or decline the file. When a file is sent to you, you have to double-click to accept it. It is stored in the folder shown here, but this can of course be changed in the Tools Options menu. You can make an audio call by clicking on the Call menu. Again, the recipient could decline to accept the call. You could also make a video call, although this does not at present integrate with the existing video conferencing service. You'll notice that you see your outgoing video in a small window. I shall disconnect this call and let you see how an incoming video call looks. You'll see that you must click this button to start transmitting your video. It is also possible to arrange meetings by selecting Meet Now from the menu. In most cases, you would accept the default setting at this dialog box. Lync prompts you of the next step, and you add participants by clicking on the People icon and selecting Invite by Name. If you select a person who is offline, you will receive this message. You can continue adding people and the names will be shown in a list here. If you hover over the names, you can see that one person is a moderator, the originator of the meeting. You would normally use audio during a meeting, or you can text. You can set up a poll to ask people to vote on issues. There are a number of sharing options. The whiteboard is useful. There is a small toolbar at the bottom. When you are in a call, it is possible to record the whole conversation. A small message appears at the bottom left of the window. The stop button is on the right at the bottom of the window. The screen recording is saved as a video. When the recording is stopped, the dialog box enables you to see where the recording is stored and in which format. You can always return to previous recordings using the recording manager.